Hey everybody, welcome to a brand new series, Fallout 3, Enter the Wasteland with Callan Hale. Since the new show came out, revitalized my want to pick up this series for Fallout Friday. Every Friday will be about a 30 to 45 minute episode. Hope you are all enjoying. So let us get into the action with a brand new game. I'm going to skip over the character creation stuff. But we're going to do the intro anyway.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves. Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl?
Okay. I know I said I would skip character creation, but I thought... might as well go with it, because it is integral to Fallout 3.
It's a boy.
For the most part.
Boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
Callan.
That's a good name, don't you think? It fits you perfectly.
Looks like look this player name. Projection.
Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
I am just going to randomize the... hell out of this. Oh, come on. Yes. Let's see. Get it close to my actual hair color. And... we'll go with shaggy sideburns. That's about as far as we're going to go with character creation this playthrough.
See that, Catherine?
Four has a lot more.
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're just... James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
We need a doctor, not a dead man. This one's on the house. Fail to meet my expectations. No,
don't look straight into the light, pal.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations, fascinating boys, this place will feel just like home.
Come on over here, son.
I have to go in and check my... I think it's under display. Because I'm not getting... subtitles all should be on.
Come on, walk to Daddy.
Daddy.
There you go. My goodness.
There we go.
Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
The special book.
Daddy.
You're special. Strength. S is for strength, and that means I am strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. We'll give ourselves a point in strength. Perception. P is for perception. A long, funny world, it means what I tasted and smelled, saw, and heard. E is for endurance. That's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. Definitely going to put a point in endurance. C is for charisma, why people think I'm great. I make friends, make my friends all laugh and smile whenever they want to hate. I is for intelligence. It means I'm really smart. I use my brain for lots of stuff, like science, math, and art. Yes to intelligence. A is for agility, that's how I get around. I move real fast, easy, and I never make a sound. Because agility is for sneak. L is for luck, and it's simple, you see. It means that good things always happen to me. And I'll throw a point into luck. I'm not too worried about charisma or perception at the moment, because I'm not looking to go long range right now. Lock pick of 100. Well, that would take me a while to get.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
All right. And now we follow. Watching the show, they did a really good job on how they set up some of the vaults.
Experiment to prepare.
If you have not watched it yet, I highly recommend.
Surprise!
This is going to episode is going to be probably up till we get to adulthood and exit the vault.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibility.
Nice.
So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it.
I have one of those on my shelf.
You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Alvin,
enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we?
Quest had a great fast.
Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
I really have no idea.
Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no
nice.
Pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10. Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on you.
Level 1, there's my special... skills. I have no perks.
Yeah, Paul. Why don't you introduce
Happy
us to your
Happy
new
birthday,
best friend.
Sonny.
Who do you mean, dork face here?
Happy birthday,
Happy
Sonny.
Happy birthday, dork face.
Enjoying yourself?
Are you having a nice time? I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. I do not allow the fact that Amata is my daughter to compromise my position as overseer. I gave her all the appropriate paternal encouragement, of course, but I could not contribute extra vault resources. That is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
Yeah, so you're a dick.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And is all for you. No sharing required today.
Hey, happy birthday, Nosebleed.
Andy, wait.
Nice chipboard. What is that?
Nice
is it, 3000 A models?
Get lost.
What? This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Why have to make you cry?
Oh, no.
Can I tell you to stop bothering us?
Daddy,
shut up!
Happy birthday.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer. Mrs. Palmer said I didn't have to share. Who's talking about sharing, moron? I want the whole thing. Now, are you gonna give me that sweet roll, or am I gonna have to give you a knuckle sandwich?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? We'll see about that. You're gonna be sorry, you little...
Do you think we surprised him?
Say,
I'm
Uncle!
Sure, Vidamata. Never suspected a thing.
Butch, what do you think
now
you're doing?
On,
leave him alone!
Enjoy yourself.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party.
I was hoping I could hit him back.
God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Enjoying yourself?
You all right, son?
Thanks for coming,
Come
Stanley.
On,
I know you...
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it.
True.
Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
We're busy with the water purifier.
Yeah.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
I got one. The Mackers. Super cool.
Nope. Items. Apparel. Baseball cap.
Cool, right?
How are you
Jeez,
enjoying
Holly,
the party,
who's
Mrs.
the head of the
Palmer?
Gang? You or me?
I help with the
no
decorations,
way.
You know.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about?
It was nothing, just boys being boys.
That's fine, son. I'm glad to see you're not letting Butch bully you. He's gonna be a handful in a few years if his mother doesn't take him in hand. Well, no harm done then. Why don't you get back to enjoying your party?
Hello, Officer Gomez. I'm glad
I talked to everybody, I thought.
I'm glad
get
to
lost,
be here.
Butt breath.
It's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know.
Are you having a nice time?
Plus, well, I like parties.
Jonas?
Hey, Doc. Sure thing, Officer Gomez.
You let me know if that Pip-Boy ever gives
you
any trouble.
I'll send him right down.
Bolt snakes. What do you guys
Happy
think?
Birthday.
I don't know.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present.
Nice.
Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Maybe.
Well, I don't know. I've got to think about it.
Apartment.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
And I will read that poem right before the end of the episode. Actually, let's read it right now. I'm still getting used to the controls again. Misc. It should have been under Misc, right? Or is that under Data? Notes. Gray walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation. Little hands groping in subterranean uncertainty. Mommy, Daddy, am I dead? Nay, nay, reborn into purifying fluorescence. A face emerges strong and male, father to me, father to all. Overseer our lives, our eternities, harshness of discipline, harshness of love, obedience my savior. Larva to pupa, pupa to worker, buzz, buzz. One with the steel honeycomb. 10 lies within the 101, significant at last, till gray seeps from walls to hair to soul, then eternal slumber, the sweet sleep of incineration. Okay, that's morbid as hell.
What are you doing down here, young
man? Hey, Jonas!
I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself. Your dad is waiting to give...
Are you ready for your surprise? The overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so... I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't. Unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Give you your present. Or should we just keep it?
There's a reactor.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Where's Jonas?
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Draw a weapon.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine.
Nope. Missed.
Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
smile.
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem right? Anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter. So
6 years later.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
Anything I need to know about the goat?
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault.
Yeah, spoilers.
Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the Overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. That's what the Overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe.
Foreshadowing!
Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen, there's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate about life, about love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Take care, son. I got out of here. Good luck.
You found a Vault Tech limited edition bobblehead. The inscription on the base reads, "The smart man knows a bandage only hides his wound. Your medicine skill has permanently increased by 10 points. Nice. I won't be doing any kind of, like, bobblehead hunting or any of that in this playthrough.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh? Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us. Morning, Doc. How's things?
Have you had a chance to look over?
I will be exploring the wastes and looking in pretty much everything I can look into. But also, it won't be.
You better stay away. I don't want you to catch what I've got.
God, Butch, why don't you just leave me alone?
Life support systems.
What are you gonna
tell
do?
Tell her, Butch.
Go run and tell your daddy on. Yeah. What do you want? None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me? Maybe you're right. We can deal with her later. Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time.
I wanted to hit him.
You're the boss. Sorry. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father is the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
This headache just won't go away. Even with the pills you gave me last week, it's the life.
See the sunshine of friendship. We're all in this together.
Hey, Susie, what's new?
Well, not much. Our heater's.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
Yes, I think I'd like that.
I'll take the goat. And shortly we'll wrap this episode for episode 1 of Fallout Friday.
Now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves.
I'd like this first episode to get us to the wasteland.
Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question 1. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question 2. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question 3. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
Lead the boy to safety and turn him into the overseer.
Question 4. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
I'd probably be the designated hitter.
Question 5. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do? Question 6. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question 7. Oh no! You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
Large dose of anti-mutagen agent.
Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
Trade comic book for one of your own valuable possessions.
Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking, and... Question 2.
Who's in the bolts?
Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate, or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Get out of my face.
All finished?
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
They say the goat never lies. According to this, you're slated to be the next vault chaplain. God help
wow.
us all. Yes, it's refreshing to see such youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
So, melee weapons is increased. Medicine, melee weapons. I'd rather go with science or... You mean the detective skill, pick someone's pocket. Science. Okay. Let's go with that.
Hello. Hey.
Back off.
Come on, Freddy. Finish up. I'll see you tomorrow, bright and early.
Anything is possible. Even an
A. 3 years later.
Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you. He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men. They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas
and
was your friend.
As I mentioned, this will be a longer
we've
episode.
We've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck!
Baseball bat.
I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
We might... I want to both make this the entrance to the vault or the wasteland episode, but I know how long this portion takes. So what we are going to do for this Fallout Friday is this is where we're going to wrap this episode up. And as always, if you did enjoy it, leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below. Hit that bell notification so you get notified when we upload new episodes every Friday. 2 a.m. MST, this episode is going to go live. And I have to thank everybody for tuning in. As always, for the Wasteland, please make sure to hydrate. Medicaid if you have to. Eat some good food. Be kind to yourselves. Be kind to each other. And remember, war never changes. for this episode of Fallout 3. Talon Hill signing off.